We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Dark Knight's Death Metal, The Last Stories of the DC Universe, Issue 1. This is a one-shot from DC Comics, and this takes place between Issues 5 and 6 of Dark Knight's Death Metal. This is a series of short stories, including The Titans in Together by Joshua Williamson, James Tynion IV, Scott Snyder, with Travis Moore on art, Tamara Bonvillain on colors, Darren Bennett on letters, Green Lantern in Last Knights, written by Jeff Lemire, with art by Raphael Albuquerque, Ivan Placencia colors, Steve Wan's letterer. Then the next story is The Question with Wonder Woman, written by Mariko Tamaki, Daniel Sampier art, Adriana Lucas colors, Sadia Temfuente letterer, Green Arrow and Black Canary in the Dust of a Distant Storm, written by Gail Simone, art by Megan Hetrick, Marissa Louise colorist, Travis Lanham letterer. Then we have an Aquaman story called Whalefall, Christopher Bella wrote that, Christopher Monaghan artist, Enrica Aaron Angoli colorist, Dave Sharp letterer. Then we cut to the Bat Family and We Fight for Love by Cecile Castellucci, Mirka Andolfo artist, Andrew Dalhaus colorist, Sadia Temafuante letterer. And then Superman and Man of Tomorrow, written by Mark Waid, Francis Manapul art and colors, Josh Reed letterer. So the Titans story is actually the bookend piece, and Donna Troy is kind of walking around talking to all the Titans. Then Wally West shows up and we get some kind of stupid resolution. DC's still kicking Wally in the nuts for some reason. That's kind of the summation of it. And then the Green Lantern story is Hal kind of spending his last hours trying to fly around, and he runs into Sinestro and they have a little moment. The art in this one's really rough. Where the first story had more traditional comic book art and looked fine, this one has some seriously weird proportions and exaggerated features. Sinestro looks okay, but Hal looks really bizarre and he doesn't seem to have any lips. I didn't like that story, and I didn't like the art. Then we've got the Wonder Woman story, where she is wandering around trying to get ready for the fight, and she talks to the Riddler for a second for some asinine reason. This was a boring throwaway story, but the art was okay. The Green Arrow and Black Canary story, written by Gail Simone, was total garbage. The art is horrifically bad. It looks amateurish at best. I'm pretty sure a high schooler drew this. It is disgusting looking. Everybody looks like 12-year-olds dressed up as adults. And the plot makes almost no sense. It's just pointless and stupid, and it's wedged in there for no purpose whatsoever. The Aquaman story, this story is sort of supposed to be a deep philosophical thing about why he did what he did, and it's so boring. And it was trying way too hard to be like this deep philosophical moment and touching, and it really just comes off as trite and hackneyed. The Bat Family story is more of the same of that theme, where they're all getting together for a pointless meeting where they just sort of blather for a minute, and Barbara's a total rude person to Dick, and she uses their possible last moments to just kind of blame him for stuff and complain while Batman emotionally validates her. And it's got some really lazy dialogue and pseudo hipster humor that just isn't funny. The art is just as bad as the story. It's terrible. Then we got Superman building a time travel device that lets him go back in time for 1 hour. So instead of saving that for, the final battle they're about to face, where he could be everywhere at once, now he uses it to fly around and build solar panels in a school for an Earth that probably won't exist in a day. So he wastes that potential item, but the story is decent at least. And then we close out the second half of that kicking Wally in the nuts story. I didn't like most of these stories. Some of them were decently written. Like, the Titan story was technically well composed, but it wasn't a good story. It just missed all the beats. It didn't really go anywhere, and it was just sort of, hey, look, here's the universe dying. Let's tell everybody how crappy Wally West is. And so many of these stories were just bad end pieces that really didn't belong anywhere. The Green Lantern story really bothered me because the art was pretty terrible, but a lot of the background pieces looked like photographs that had been manipulated. So it looked even more lazy because of that. Too many of these stories were just trash. This was a $9 book, and it reads like a bunch of bad backup stories out of annuals. That Batman story was really garbage, too. Oh, that was offensively bad. Not as bad as the Green Arrow and Black Canary one, because that was... ugh. These are trash. Most of this stuff is trash. It's not worth reading. It's not worth the money. You could have skipped this. I see what they were going for was supposed to be these sentimental send-offs, but they really fell flat on almost every front because they fell into a lot of these same tired and overused cliches that DC and Marvel have been doing for years now. When we meet Black Arrow in this, of course she has the side of her head in cornrows and slightly shaved, so she's just a generic looking character because every new hero has that. It's just lazy. Everything about this felt like it was a paycheck and not a work of passion or love. There was barely any action. It was just sappy, quasi-emotional stuff that really fell flat. I've seen Hallmark movies with more heart than this. It's just lazy all around. It's not worth the $9. If you're going to get this, get it in one of the trade paperbacks that is going to compile a bunch of these books together. I didn't think this was worth anywhere close to cover price. This was skippable, hot garbage that really was just a marketing ploy to get you to buy an overpriced book. The formatting's nice. It's in perfect bound format. The paper quality's really good. That doesn't salvage the largely garbage book with a lot of really bad art and really bad storytelling. Save yourself the money, buy something better. Buy a couple of indie books, you'll be a lot happier. That'll do it for this one. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel in other ways, be sure and share the link around, recommend it to your friends on social media, etc. If you want to support me with a one-time financial donation, you can do it through Streamlabs, which accepts PayPal, or you can support me monthly on Patreon and get exclusive videos from both this channel and Roll for Sanity. And if you just want to get some cool merch for yourself, check out my Teespring store. All those links are in the description, and as always, we hope to see you on the next one.